The Department of Health and Human Services says about 10,000 of the almost 12,000 children now in its care are unaccompanied minors. Most are teenagers, and 13% are younger than 10. The First Lady's visit came a day after President Trump signed an executive order to cease the separation of migrant families at the border, saying his wife's advice was key to his decision.
My wife feels very strongly about it.
Last weekend, she said, we need to be a country that follows all laws, but also a country that governs with heart. But tonight, more than 2,300 children separated from their parents are in limbo. There are mounting questions about how they'll be reunited and growing confusion within the government. Today, a U.S. attorney's office in Texas told NBC News some pending criminal cases against parents who'd been separated from a child would be dismissed, but the Justice Department later saying that's not true. The Defense Department now sending extra military lawyers to help prosecute cases. How overwhelmed is the immigration system in South Texas right now?
There are not enough resources to do what the government wants to do right now.
Today, mayors from major U.S. cities gathered at the border, calling this a humanitarian crisis.
The reason that those children cannot be reunified is because the system has been overwhelmed by this policy.
Despite repeated requests, our cameras haven't been allowed inside migrant children's shelters around the country. But new images released by HHS show living conditions inside facilities in Florida and Virginia. Kids doing homework, eating meals at cafeteria-style tables, and playing soccer. For the youngest, there are cribs, high chairs, and small beds with brightly colored linens. The Pentagon is now preparing to house as many as 20,000 migrant children on military bases. And tonight, the Justice Department has agreed to release a child separated from his mother from Guatemala after he sued in federal court. Lester.
Gabe Gutierrez in McAllen, Texas. Thank you.